Hey guys, and welcome back to another Train Simulator video. You will be operating the 1A23 855 Holyhead to London Euston service from Llandudno Junction as far as Chester. Today you'll be calling at Llandudno Junction, Colwyn Bay, Ryle, Prestel, Flint and Chester. At Chester, another driver will take over from you. Okay then. Green signals, so that's good. Put the daylights on like so, and let's get going. Let's put the wipers on as well since it's snowing. First stop is, oops, I don't know why you're going. We need to pick up passengers, my bad. That was close. I was about to depart the station without picking up passengers, so good thing we stopped in time. Calling at that Llandudno Junction. Just gonna wait for passengers to your board and then we can move on to the next stop, which is Colwyn Bay. We are driving a 10-car train, that's which is very nice. We're actually driving a long train this time, it's nice to see. Okay, let's get going. Got class 175 there. I don't think a 10 car train will fit on most of the platforms that we'll be stopping at, so we might have to just go to the right end of the platform. And whatever fits on the platform fits, you know? It is a pretty long train. Made up of two 5-car class 221s. Speed limit is going up to 45 miles an hour now. And as you can probably tell already, it is snowing. Who knows, we might get some snow in London this year. If we're lucky? Probably not actually. Maybe just some ice. So we're going to be stopping in Colwyn Bay via Abigail and then picking up passengers for the rest of the journey. Try another speed. Nice screenshot, why not? And another one. Speed limit is going up to 85 miles now, which is good. Then again, we have to, only got 3 miles till our next stop, so we'll probably have to slow down anyway. Last 175. Coming the other way. They're trying to race us, but I don't think they'll win. But we are coming up to Colwyn Bay now, so let's slow down. Our ETA looks just about fine, I think. Yeah, we should reach on time. Even though we left Llandudno Junction and then stopped and then picked up passengers, which kind of wasted like 30 seconds or so, but we should be okay. wonder if we could fit a 10 car train on this platform. I'm guessing maybe like eight, the first 8 cars will probably fit, and the rear 2 cars probably not, in my opinion. Colwyn Bay, platform 2. Platform looks long though, so who knows? We might actually just fit a 10 car train. Might have slowed on a bit too much, a bit early there. Yeah, I think we can fit a 10 car train, yep, definitely. More than enough room. There we go. Perfect. And perfectly on time as well. That's not too bad. Let's get a nice screenshot. This train's for London Euston. Unfortunately, we can't go all the way to London Euston. That would be a pretty long journey, I will admit. If we did went all the way to Euston, but we're not going to today, only to Chester. Which I'm fine about, because I don't really like very long journeys, unfortunately. Then again, if it was to London Euston, then I would be more than willing to do that, because it's my home route. But I definitely would prefer driving a Class 390 to London Euston, in my opinion. I do prefer it over the Class 221. Okay, when's our departure time? 47. I'm not too sure why we're spending 2 minutes at this station, anyways. So next station is going via, and then stopping at Ryle, Preston, Flint, and Chester, which is only 40 miles away. I say only 40 miles away, but we are driving a Class 221 and speed limit will go up to like at least 90 miles an hour, 85-90, so we should be good. Screenshot. No trespassing and only staff only. But we are staff, so we should be good. Okay, this train's ready to depart. Mind the doors. I believe we've got maximum points for that, so that's good. Let's get going. Next stop will be Ryle, which is around 10 miles away. The next one 13 miles away, 27 and then 39. So pretty much like a semi-fast service when we use them. I'm guessing once it gets close to London Euston, then it'll only stop at the big stations like Milton Central and Watford Junction. Maybe Watford Junction, actually. I don't think I've ever seen a Class 221 stop at Watford Junction, so probably moves against Central, then maybe I'll straight to London Euston then. quite a foggy day today, actually. Can't see much. Due to the horrible weather. But we are in December now, almost, so no surprise there. Let's do this to snow instead. If I can do that, I don't think I can. Okay, that never mind. It's a bit disappointing. Might as well on the instrument night. I do the cab bags on since it's a little bit dark. London Euston, welcome aboard. Almost caught the speeding again, but this time. I'm guessing that's code G. So if we move forward, this is code K, code J, code H, code E, code A, code D, code C, code B, and code E. We are going to be approaching Abigail soon, but we're going to be going via, so no need to be stopping. I wonder if we'll get some points for going via on time. I'm guessing so. Maybe like 111 or something like that. Let's go to that station and watch the train pass by. That's gonna be pretty cool. Abigail station should be just over here. There it is. Okay, let's see the train pass by. Let's pick up some speed now. Here it comes. You have 143 points for that. Okay, well, just over 4 miles, just under 3 miles, sorry. Just under 4 miles away from next destination, which is Ryle, not from one. There will probably be another speed limit change to 75 just before the station. At the moment, we are 30 seconds early, so. And we are going to be spending 2 minutes at that station for some reason, so. Might as well start slowing down now, actually. Might as well. I'm not too sure why we're spending 2 minutes at each stop. Apart from our Flint and Chester is spending 2 minutes, but I don't mind spending 2 minutes at Chester because it's quite a nice station. So what I'm thinking of doing is, there's one career mode scenario left for the North Wales Coastal, and I was thinking of doing it in a live stream, maybe either today or tomorrow at 7 p.m. UK time, or next week, Saturday or Sunday. So if you guys want to see that, then let me know. I am most likely to be doing that, because I think that would be a pretty cool for me to live stream one of the scenarios and the new routes instead. And you guys can let me know every time I pronounce something wrong, which is a lot on this route. I believe after Ryle we got Cresta, which is only like less than 5 miles away. Then we've got two long journeys to Flint and then Chester. Yeah, these two stations are quite close to each other. This station is quite long, so should have no reason why we can't stop this train on this platform, the whole time car train. Hopefully that plus 175 won't leave, because I'm going to take a nice screenshot with it. Rear doors might not open, but well, who cares? Just a nice screenshot of that, very nice. We could take another one actually. There we go. I don't think the rear, doors are not opening for some reason, even though it's on the platform, so I still haven't fixed that. It happens with every train on this game. As long as a door can be open, clearly on the platform it should open. But I guess not. Let's see what that class 175 is going to. I don't really see where it's going to, so let's check the map that's going. It's a Birmingham International to Laduna Station. I think we've done that scenario already. I believe it was the third or fourth Let's Play episode where we went from Birmingham. We didn't start in Birmingham International, we started at, I believe, Chester and went to Laduna. Continuing the journey. Super Voyager. I think his character model looks slightly new. I'm pretty sure I haven't seen that guy before. Or this woman. Okay, this train's ready to depart. Mine doors. Next stop is Prestio. I think it's called Preston. Something like that. I'm probably saying it wrong. Just got now a and we're 30 miles away from Chester now. We're up to 90 miles now, which is good. Again, spinning once is fine, spinning twice is just clearly not concentrating, you know. Oops, again, and we do have a storm anyway because we've got 2 miles away from the next station. ETA is saying that we're going to be on time, so might as well start slowing down now. And we do have a speed limit change again. A mile left to go. I guess we can sit in the passenger view and stop the train from here. I believe the platform will go this side, so this one's on this side. All trains should open now. Yeah, and the rear car doors are open as well, which is nice to see. And the stop mark is actually there. It's quite far front of the platform, actually. Lift there. At 10:04, and next stop is Flint, which is 14 miles away, and then Chester, which is 26 miles away. next up is Flint. Let's get going. We're not going to crew station. I would have thought we would go to crew if we're going to London Euston, so. Maybe there's another branch line that goes from Chester to London Euston as well as crew to London Euston. So that's kind of interesting. Unfortunately, there's nothing much to do when you're driving for over 10 miles in this type of weather where it's quite foggy, so maybe we'll see some nice AI, some class 175s, 158s, class 221s maybe, if we're lucky. One thing we don't want to be doing is speeding, so let's get off the throttle now. I need to check my map to see if there's any AI in this scenario, any more AI. So yeah, we are doing 855 Holyhead to run Euston service. Got sidings here. Between here and Flint is not much to do actually. I think this is Flint station. No, this is Chester station. Flint is all over here. So Chester is over here. Actually, we are speeding. Maybe I should keep an eye. Oops, my bad. Lost 131 points there. Maybe we shouldn't check the map while we're accelerating, so. Probably won't get a gold medal now, but that's okay. Not too bored about that anyway. I think all the scenarios we've got in gold medals, so this might be the first one where we get a silver star. I'm not too sure why I'm saying medals. I think they used to award medals instead of stars, but they changed it over the years. I'm gonna pin up speed now, so I'll just check back. So there's Chester. Maybe this one, the branch line goes to Euston. And there's this, another driver will continue the journey to crew and then to Euston, I'm guessing. That would make more sense. Would it be nice if we went all the way to our crew station at least? And maybe started at maybe Cresta or Abigail station instead? 8 miles to go. I'm guessing the water's all frozen now because of the snow. Let's actually go and look at that. Yep, pretty much all frozen now. Ice. That's nice. Nice building here. I wonder what that building is anyway. No idea. Good thing is speed limit is going up to 90 miles an hour. Bad thing is we're almost at our next station, so kind of pointless. They really put the speed limit on the perfect path routes. That's when you don't need to speed, they give you a higher speed limit. It's kind of weird. Now ETA is saying that we're 7 seconds late, so... let's go to as close to the speed limit as possible. ETA is actually going up for some reason, so that's kind of interesting. Suggesting that we're going to be even later, so we do need to... might do some late braking at Flint Station. I wonder if the train departs, like, you know, so maybe the first 5 carriages go to London Euston, and maybe the rear 5 cars maybe stay at Chester or the crew station, I'm guessing. I'm not too sure. I wonder if that happens. So I don't really see that many 10 car trains going to London Euston. Or maybe only some of them go during peak hours, since a lot more passengers are using this train during peak hours. It is a pretty long train, you have to admit. Okay, speed limit is going up to 90 miles now, which is great because in 2 miles time we have to slow down for Flint Station, so yeah. Thanks game. Or thanks whoever designed this route. In terms of whoever decided to put speed limits on this route is... I hope he doesn't do it to any other routes. There must be a reason why the speed limit goes up and down. There's nothing really here to make any difference, you know. It's just track on track all the way to Flint Station. same to Chester and Crew Station. The class 175, probably going to Landuno, I'm guessing. No, that's going from a Manchester Piccadilly to Holyhead service. Nice. That would be a pretty cool service to do in real life. Go from Manchester Piccadilly to Holyhead. Or in the game as well, but I don't think I'll ever make that route, unfortunately. Unless it's a really short route, then they might do it and sell it for $24.99. Typical Dovetail Games. We are approaching Flint Station. Platform on Flint Station doesn't seem long enough for our 10-car train, unfortunately, so we could probably fit maybe the first 5 or 6 cars on it. Like, all the other stations that we stopped at managed to fit a 10-car train, but this station definitely not. Suggesting that this is not a station where this train stops at in real life, I'm guessing. Why would you stop a 10-car train when only the first 5 or 6 cars can fit on the platform? Might be able to fit maybe. Actually, you might fit a 10-car train actually. Maybe the first 8 cars. Yeah, first 8 cars you can fit. The rear 2 cars you definitely can't fit. Yeah, the rear 2 cars definitely can't fit the platform. So that one isn't fit, and this one. To be fair, even this one can't fit. The rear one can't open, but this one can open. The game is choosing not to open it. Anyways, we've got one final destination to go. Is Flint. We stopped at Flint. Chester, and then another driver will take over to London Euston. Chester to Landuno. I think that's another scenario that we have done already on the channel. And that scenario is actually you can do on the game, the full journey from Landuno to Chester, so that's good. Like, the service that we're doing today is not really. The majority of it we're not actually doing because obviously we didn't start in Holyhead. We're not going to London Euston either, so we're pretty much doing like maybe 20-25% of the journey, full journey from Holyhead to London Euston, but what can you do? Limit change that's coming up, 75 miles an hour. actually don't need an AWS for this route because I know that the speed limit will always go down to 75 miles an hour eventually. ETA is good, around a minute early. Just under 10 miles away from Chester. So this line goes to Ponton. Interesting. To be fair, on the actual map it shows you where the branch line goes when you reach our crew station. So this one goes to Manchester. It says Winsford, but I believe somebody said it goes to Manchester, that part, that route. So maybe it's this one. Let's go to Sandbach. Oops. Goes to Nantwich and Shrewsbury, Radway Green. I'm guessing this one that goes down goes to Newstead. Yeah, that one goes to a Stafford. So after he goes to Stafford, probably calls that Rugby, Miltonville Central, and goes all the way to Newstead, I'm guessing. I think it's the first one we've seen actually in this scenario. Where's that going to? London News to New Holyhead, let's do the return journey. Okay, let's go over 6 miles left in through Chester, so we should get a speed limit change very soon. We're currently on 719 points and we'll probably get like 140 for reach on time, so that's equivalent to 850 something, so I believe we need 900 to get a gold star, so we'll get a silver at least, which is not too bad considering we lost so many points in terms of speeding. It would be really cool if you could see this map, maybe on a HUD or somewhere on the train, like over here, instead of having to click on this and then look at the map. It is that way you can keep an eye on the speed limit and check the map at the same time. Sounds are pretty bad on the train, but I believe they are slightly improved off the class 2-0. from Gulf War Games. But I will try to get a sound pack for this train when the Armstrong Powers have their sale. And there's a few other trains I need a sound pack for, like the class 455, maybe the class 375 as well. And a few other trains that I drive a lot. It's so foggy now, I can't even see the next speed of it anyway, so. Or next signal, I mean. Yep, the speed limit changed to 50 miles now. Change of 30 miles now. So we'll slow down in a minute. I believe we just passed the line where it goes towards Wrexham General. Yes, it is. What if Wrexham Central would make a lot more sense of the station name, but I'm not too sure why it's called General. Wrexham General. It's a bit weird in my opinion. Chester, where we'll have a few minutes break, and then we'll have a driver change, as I can't really be bothered to go over to John Houston, I'm guessing. I think that's a good excuse. We've got yellow signals, so we are somewhat early. The signal just before Chester might be red. So you have to keep an eye. Is that? No, we got green signal, which is interesting. But I thought we would have a yellow signal since we're like a minute early. Let me know in the comments below which station you like more, Chester or Froome. I think both stations are very nice, but I feel like Chester is slightly better in my opinion. I'm not too sure why. This looks a lot nicer in my opinion. I don't believe we'll be changing track since this. We're not terminating at Chester, we're going to stop at Chester where the train will continue. And I'm pretty sure this station will have a long enough platform. Enough probably for a patrol car train actually, I'm guessing. Okay, so let's start slowing down. Just overshot it by a little bit, but that's okay. Got a class 158 there. And you know what we're going to be doing. We're going to be taking a screenshot, obviously. Station is very nice. Bit basic, but you've got always these beams up here. That's a very nice building. Got this like a footbridge, it looks like. This bridge reminds me of the bridge when you leave Paddington Station. You know what I mean. Class 158, 862 points, you have arrived on time at Chester and given plenty of time for the driver to take over the service you're not used to. Thank you very much. Do you win that silver star? Yep, only a silver star. We lost 131 points in like one go, I think. Yeah, over here we lost minus 12, minus 12, minus 15, minus 18. That's why we lost most of the points, but that's okay. But yeah, I'll end the video there. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, give it a like, share with your friends, and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys.